بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I welcome you to another episode of our series, السفرة الكرام, تجويد, the art of reciting the Quran. We know that the Quran was revealed over a period of 23 years because the Prophet ﷺ started the revelation when he was 40 years old and the revelation finished at his death or before his death when he was 63 years old. So the Quran was revealed over more than two decades of time. However, not the entire revelation is similar in style. We have differences in the style and in the content of various verses of the Quran. And the scholars of the Quran have demarcated, have partitioned, if you like, the verses of the Quran into two categories. Those verses revealed before the Hijrah, before the migration of the Prophet ﷺ from Mecca to Medina, and these are called Makki verses. And the second category, those verses which are revealed after the migration of the Prophet ﷺ to Medina, and these are called, obviously, Madani verses. So the Makki and the Madani verses are those verses. Makki verses are revealed before the Hijrah, and Madani verses revealed after the Hijrah. And the scholars of the Quran have characterized these two sets of verses with different characteristics. And this only makes sense because the Quran was revealed to cater to the situation of the Muslims. And the situation of the Muslims was very different in Mecca than it was in Medina. In Mecca, they were a minority. They were being persecuted. Okay, and the laws of Islam had not been revealed. There was no zakah, there was no fasting, there was no, you know, anything. It was only the spirituality, the aqidah, the basis of morality. What should a Muslim believe? Whereas in Medina, they had an entire Islamic state with them. And also the laws were being revealed. So the scholars of tafsir, the scholars of the Quran, have characterized Makki verses that generally, the verses revealed before the Hijrah, they deal with the broad essentials of faith. Who is Allah? What is the Day of Judgment? What will happen in Jannah and now? They also deal with morality, of being a good person. Also they deal with the stories of the prophets of old. This was primarily a Makki theme. The Madani verses, they primarily deal with worship, with how to worship Allah, with the laws of Islam, the laws of inheritance, the laws of marriage and divorce. Okay? They also deal with how to interact with other religious communities. Remember that the Muslims in Mecca, they were a minority. They were no Christians, Jews, nothing there. When they came to Medina, they were the majority and there were also non-Muslim minorities there. Jews, there were Christians that would come visit. So the laws were revealed about how to interact with them. Now all of this only goes to show you how completely our knowledge of the Quran has been preserved. Not only has the book itself been preserved, but rather the knowledge related to it has been preserved. In fact, the famous companion Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said that I swear by Allah, there is not a single verse in the Quran except that I know where it was revealed, when it was revealed, and concerning whom it was revealed, where, when, and the reason for its revelation. And if there was any person that was more knowledgeable than me about the Quran, I would travel great distances to go study from him. So the purpose of this is to really increase our iman that so much of the Quran has been preserved. Not only the verses, but rather when, where, how, what, why, everything related to the Quran has been preserved. It is as Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, we have revealed this book and of a surety we will preserve it. Getting back to our topic of tajweed, in our last lesson we had discussed the primary rules of the letter Ra. When will the Ra be heavy and when will it be light? And we said that the majority of rules of Ra pertain to the previous episode, the Fatha and the Dhamma will generally be heavy and the Kasra will be light. And we said that today's episode will discuss the exceptions or the more difficult rules. So we will put up the same chart of the heaviness and the lightness. And these rules might be a little bit more difficult, but please bear with me. And once again, firstly realize that this is just a simple, if you like, equation. You plug in the things, you get out the result. If this applies, this will occur. Okay. Secondly, if you don't understand it, don't worry, because these rules hardly apply. Maybe only 5% of the Ra's in the Quran, the rules we'll discuss today. The vast majority of Ra's are very easy, and we discussed the rules in the last episode. We stated in the last episode that the Ra, when it is silent and has a kasra before it, it will be what? It will be light. Aha, here is an exception now. If the Ra is silent and before it is a kasra, but there is something called a hamzatul wasl, it will not be light, it will be heavy. So in order to understand this rule, we have to explain what a Hamzatul Wasl is. A Hamzatul Wasl is an invisible Hamza, if you like. It is something which has been added there in order to pronounce the word properly. The word starts with a sukun. But you cannot start something with a sukun. How can you start with a sukun? Therefore, in order to start the word with a sukun, the scholars of the language, the Arabs, they have added something called the Hamzatul Wasl. Anytime a word starts with a sukun, then you must put a Hamzatul Wasl before it in order to start saying the word. This is called Hamzatul Wasl. The point is that anytime there is a ra, which is silent, after a Hamzatul Wasl, then it will be heavy, even if there is a kasra before it. Let me give you an example. Open up the Quran. These are not that common, but Surah Yusuf, verse 81. We'll look up some examples now, so that you understand what I'm talking about. Surah Yusuf, obviously the famous surah in the Quran, in the 13th juz, the 11th surah. Verse number 81. We find the first word in this ayah is what? Irji'u. Okay? Irji'u. Notice now, the ra is what? Silent. Silent first. There's a sukun there. Mm-hmm. Okay? The ra is silent. Yes. Before the ra is what? This is what we call Hamzatul Wasl. Mm-hmm. This is a Hamzatul Wasl. Yes. It has been placed there because if you were to start this word, how are you going to start it from a silent ra? You cannot pronounce the silent ra. You need a letter or a vowel before it. Therefore, the Hamzatul Wasl has been placed. Mm-hmm. Okay? So the Hamzatul Wasl acts as a, if you like, stepping stone to get to the word. If there is a Hamzatul Wasl, then the ra will be heavy, even if there is a kasra before it. Notice we said ir, which is a kasra.
Yeah.
But even then the ra was what? Heavy or light?
Heavy.
Heavy. It is not light. And had it been light, we would have said is, but we didn't. We said irji'u, a heavy ra. Okay? So this is one example of this rule here, that when the ra is preceded by a Hamzatul Wasl, it will be heavy, even if there is a kasra before it. Another example, let us go to Surah At-Talaq, verse 4. Surah At-Talaq is in the 28th juz of the Quran. And it is the 65th surah. Look at verse number 4.